Okay, hello students. Myself is Prakash Biradar, assistant professor in the Department of Pharmacology, KLE College of Pharmacy, Belagavi. So today I am delivering the lecture over the antihypertensive drugs. Okay, the pharmacology of antihypertensive drugs. Okay, so in these drugs, the pharmacology of the antihypertensive drugs. So these are the contents are there. So this is the content: introduction, definition, pathophysiology of the hypertensions, and a little bit of epidemiological and classifications of antihypertensive drugs, and receptors, drug receptor actions, and also pharmacology of each drug of the classes. So briefly I will take it. Okay, so this is the learning object. After completion of this topic, the student can able to deliver what are the classifications of the antihypertensive and antihypertensive mechanisms, like the diuretics, that is the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, beta blockers, alpha blockers, or calcium channel blockers, or vasodilators, or central sympatholytic agents, and pharmacology of the above mentioned group of the drugs also. Along with that, the common adverse effect and some of the clinical usage. Now coming to the introduction of the antihypertensive, or what do you know about the hypertensions? As we are knowing that doctor, when you go to the doctor, first they will assess the whether the person is what kind of the blood pressure is or her will be the. So they will assess if there is any hypertensions. So the hypertension related many of the diseases it will be caused. So because of that, they used to assess the or estimate the blood hypertensions, blood pressures. So the definition is the pressure exerted. Hypertension is nothing but the pressure exerted over the lateral wall of the blood vessels is called as the blood pressures. Normally it is of the systolic, that is the contraction of the heart. So it is of 120 mmHg, and the diastolic of 80 mmHg. So that is during the relaxation. If there is in the hypertensive, if there is any elevation in the systolic pressure of more than 140 mmHg and diastolic of the 90 mmHg, that condition the patient is said to be an hypertensive. So these are the some of the symptoms of hypertensive that will include the headaches, shortness in the breathing, loose, that is nose bleeding will take place, flushing, dizziness, chest pain, visual changes, blood in the urea. So these are the some of the symptoms. So coming to the majority of the hypertension, the class, different classes of the hypertensions, there are two type of hypertensions, primary and secondary. The primary is that the cause of the disease of the hypertension is unknown, but whereas in secondary the definite cause will be there. The main aim of the control of the atrial pressure, which will prevent the end organ damages like the cerebrovascular or the renals, and it will reduces even the premature death also. So coming to the epidemiology, hypertension in one of the main risk in the India for the other diseases, like the even for the other diseases like the myocardial infarctions or diabetic and other kind of the diseases. Reported hypertension in the male is of 13.8%, and whereas female is of 8.8% in the age between 15 to 49 or 15 to 54 respectively. It will be of this epidemiological data we are taking. So coming to the different type of hypertensions, essential, that is the primary, what we call as. So this order of the effect of the blood pressure is mainly unknown origin will be there. Whereas in secondary, that may be caused due to the one of the known factor will be there. It may be the environmental factor like stress, which will be increased, then it will causes and the hypertensions or intake of the sodium or obesity, smoking, all these are coming under the secondary hypertensions. So usually our body will be regulating minute to minute or second to second of the changes in the blood pressures, but the regulations failure, it will be leading into the hypertensions. So one of the regulator is that hydraulic equations of the blood pressure is nothing but an cardiac output into the resistance of the passage through the peripheral arterioles or vascular vessels. So physiologically, the cardiac output and peripheral resistance or pre-capillary arteriole pressure resistance is mainly maintained by minute to minute by the arterioles or post-capillary venules or heart or even the kidneys. So it will depending upon the volume of intravascular fluid mechanisms, so it will be maintaining. Even the baroreceptors, like the what we call as an pressure receptors, what we call as a pressure receptor, which will be present in the arterioles or in the carotid arteries, or humoral mechanisms, like some of the humoral mechanisms like the sympathetic and parasympathetic, that is the autonomic nervous system, even the angiotensin aldosterone systems, that can also regulate all these four sides of the regulations of the blood pressures. Even the local agent like the nitric oxides, which can also be helpful in the regulations of the blood pressures. So along with that, some of the to monitor all these component, baroreceptor, renal blood volume, to set in the higher level. So all these can be interfered by the antihypertensive drugs to normalize. So this is one of the component, baroreceptor. So baroreceptors are the pressure, whatever the ejections of the blood from the aorta, it will assess the pressure of that particular during the contraction or during the relaxations. So if there is any change in the blood pressure, that is 120 by 80 mmHg, then it will be assessed and it will be reporting towards the, through the sensory neurons, it will be reporting towards the vasomotor centers. So these vasomotor centers, if there is any increase in the blood pressure, then it will, through the autonomic nervous system, it will decreases, that is, it will inhibit the sympathetic activity and it will activate parasympathetic and it will decreases the cardiac output and also peripheral resistance, blood vessels, vasodilation will take place and simultaneously there will be decrease in blood pressure, it will be takes place. And if there is any low in the blood pressure, then there will be a, that will be assessed by the baroreceptor and again there will be motor, vasomotor center will be activated, autonomic nervous system will be activated and it will causes and the activations of the sympathetic system and there will be increase in cardiac output and also peripheral resistance also, or renal constriction, blood vessel constriction is also takes place. So this is one type of the regulations of the blood. And the second is that renal responses. So in renal responses is also very main play and very important role depending upon the blood volume and also renal pressures. If there is any disturbance in the blood volume and the renal pressure, then there will be activations of the certain hormones or what we call as an renin. If there is any decrease in the renal arteriolar pressure of the blood pressure, and a sympathetic activation will take place. So these sympathetic activations, so this will be analyzed by the juxtaglomerulus apparatus and even in the macula densa. They will even assess the ions also, like sodium, if there is decrease in the concentration of sodium ions. So at that time, the sympathetic activation will take place and the renin production will take place. This renin will be converted into the angiotensin 1 and later by the angiotensin converting enzyme into the angiotensin 2. So angiotensin 2 is a potent vasoconstrictor and by doing so, it will increase the arteriolar, renal arteriolar pressure also. And simultaneously, the angiotensin 2 and angiotensin 3, they will activate aldosterone systems. So sodium absorption will take place and increase in the blood volume is also one of the component, which will increase the sodium level also. So this is how the renal system, it will be regulating. Now coming to the antihypertensive drugs. So there are different classes of the drugs are there, like the diuretics. So the first line therapy is that if there is minimal hypertension will be there, then they will go for the first line therapy like the diuretics. In that, thiazides, that is the low ceiling diuretics, hydrochlorothiazides and chlorothalidones, and high ceiling, that is the furosemide, up to, they are called to be high ceiling because they will up to the 10 liters of the blood water content of the body can be easily removed. So they are called to be high ceilings. And potassium sparing, one of the side effect of the diuretics is hypokalemia it will produce, or decrease in the potassium content. So because of that, that is also leading to the some of the complications. To overcome that, potassium sparing diuretics are also there, like the spironolactone, triamterene, and amiloride. So mechanism of actions of these all are acting over the renal tubules at the different site, and they will decrease the reabsorption of sodium and bicarbonate ions. Now coming to the second class, angiotensin converting enzymes or ACE inhibitors, like the captopril, lisinopril, enalapril, ramipril, fosinopril. So these are the drugs which can inhibit the angiotensin 2 and decreases the peripheral resistance and also blood volume also. So the angiotensin ACE inhibitors, they are said to be. Now coming to the another class of the drugs, that is the angiotensin blocking receptor blockings. So 81 and 82 receptors are there. So usually the angiotensin 2 will be acting over the 81, and which is related to the blood pressures. Losartan, candesartans, and valsartans, and temnisartans are the drugs which will block the binding of the angiotensin 2 to its receptors. Okay. So these are the coming to the another class, that is the centrally acting drugs. They are said to be like the clonidine and methyldopa, which will be acting on the alpha 2 receptor, which will decrease the sympathetic outflow of the adrenergic outflow of or sympathetic outflow. So by doing so, it will decrease fall in BP will take place. That is, it will decrease the sympathetic outflow and decreases the beta 1 action and alpha 1 actions. So non-selective like means they will be acting on both beta 1 and as well as alpha 1. Nandolol, timolol, pindolol, labetalol are cardioselective, like the metoprolol, atenolol, ismolol, or some of the other drugs, which will be their main mechanism of actions will be they will be blocks the beta 1 receptor in the cardiac, that is myocardial muscles, and decreases the contractility and the force of contractility and also the rate. And they will block even the non-selective, like the alpha 1, which will decreases the alpha 1 vasoconstrictions or blood vessel constrictions, which will leading into the dilations. So because of these, they will causes and relaxations. And some drugs are there, they will be acting on specific of alpha 1 specific adrenergic blockers, like the prazosin, terazosins, doxazosins, phenoxybenzamines. So these are non-selective, they will be acting on both the alpha 1 and alpha 2, or pentolamines. So their main mechanism of action of the alpha adrenergic receptor is on the smooth muscles. So the blood vessels, they will be causing and relaxations. So they will block the some of the potassium or even the calcium, and they will cause us into the relaxations of the vasodilation will take place. Now coming to the another class, that is the calcium channel blocking agents, verapamil, diltiazems, nifedipines, felodipines, amlodipines, or some of other drugs which are said to be an L type of the calcium channel blocking drugs. So they will block the L type of the calcium ions in the smooth muscles, and it will cause us in the blood vessels as a relaxations. So in by doing so, it will cause us a decrease in blood pressures. So even the potassium activators like diazoxides, minoxidil, and some of the nicrandils, their action is by the leakage of potassium ions. So opening of the potassium ions leading into the hyperpolarization and relaxation of the smooth muscles of the blood vessels. Even the potent vasodilators are also there, like hydrazolines, which will be causing and potent relaxations, and also some of the alveolar and venolar drugs, like the sodium nitroprusside, which will activate the nitric oxide formations from the endothelial, and it will cause some relaxations. So these are the some of the classes of the drugs which will be used in the some of the antihypertensives. Now this is about the brief drugs discussions or the brief classification, different classification of the drugs of the antihypertensive. So this is the references. I quoted with some of the referred in the some of the website and also some of the books. So thank you.